Welcome back into the Hershey Center. Jeremy Ellis here for the 2017 NARCh Finals. We continue with pro action here on the arena rink. This time it is the ISCA Grizzlies and the Pama Labeda Golden Knights, formerly the Pama Cyclones, but with the NARCh family and their relationship with the expansion Golden Knights team, they are donning new uniforms and a new name and trying to start new traditions here at the 2017 NARCh Finals. So it's the Golden Knights and the Grizzlies coming up here next on the arena rink. Jeremy Ellis bringing it to you, possibly joined by Alex Morrison at some point. So the goaltender for the Knights, number 30, James Mello, getting the nod for Pama. And the puck is put down and into play, and we are set to go here in this NARCh Pro contest. And Pama up quickly on the puck, and with it, Walters had it go through. Aronson trying to chase it down for the Golden Knights, and it's taken back by the Grizzlies back into their own end. They battle for it, trying to get control of it there with Schultz. Schultz, one of the more feisty players that you'll see in the pro division. Him and Garsh go down to the floor as they come together. Officials Aaron Evans and Brian Burkhart communicating with the players, telling them to play through the contact. And here come the Golden Knights back the other direction now with it. Trying to feed it across, looking for Jordan Thomas. Pass was behind Thomas, and now it's stolen away. Here come the Grizzlies back the other direction now with it, and forced to chip it all the way back into their own end, and that's where Wolf will track it down for the ISCA Grizzlies. ISCA, of course, coached by Dennis Jelsic. And Rob Cherneman manning the bench, per usual, for the Cyclones, or for the Golden Knights. I'm going to have to get used to that one. Years and years of Cyclones history will still remain in the record books, but creating new entries. Here come Golden Knights back the other direction, trying to feed it up to Doran, who's cruising through the slot. Bodies come together behind the net, and here come the Grizzlies back the other direction, working quickly up the floor. Tursic tried to feed it in front. It's taken back into their own end. Joel Dolce, number 16. Number 18 is C.J. Bateman. Bateman leaves it behind his own net for Padilla. Chris Padilla leaves it off, and here come the Grizzlies back the other direction. And Bateman had the puck bounce off his stick. Cruising through the neutral zone was Walters. Walters had it skip free for a moment. Walzer had it hop over his stick, so Walzer was a nice addition to the Pama family program within the last couple years. Some of his former Buffalo Wings teammates playing on the Connick's team. There's a shot right in, and Mello had to be sharp there, as that was the first good chance there for the Grizzlies. Still no score here in the hockey game. We've played a little over 3 minutes here from the arena rink. So pass up ahead. Seamer sends it down. Walters, and a beautiful tip in there. Believe that was Nowick. And it was. Darren Nowick used his one hand on the stick to tap it home past the goaltender. Chacon And just like that, the Golden Knights have the lead here in the hockey game, 1-0. 11:26 left to go here in the first half. The goal there by Nowick makes it 1-0. Pama, Labeda, Golden Knights. Seamer chips it into the corner. He comes together with one of the Grizzlies players. Seamer had a great year in minor pro hockey. Seamer up on the puck now for the Cyclones. Sauces it all the way back down into his own end. Long outlet pass up ahead. Couldn't find the mark to Nowick. Banks off the boards over the stick of O'Connell. Taken away now. Here comes Seamer with it. Seamer wants the sauce one. He was trying to hit Nowick, who was on the fly, but it was knocked down. Good stick work there by Was Tursik. And there's a shot that goes up off the goaltender. And he'll hand it off to the official. 10:18 left to go here in the first period. Our score is 1-0. Golden Knights over the Grizzlies. Grizzlies in about their seventh or eighth year of playing in the pro division. They're not a team that you would consider a threat to win the pro championship, but they are one of those teams that can put a monkey wrench into other teams' plans. They have made the playoffs in the pro division in the past. Given people always close games. They've continued to shuttle in some new talent. There's a chance there, and it went off the stick of Was Tursik. Thomas wraps it back. Walters has it. He wanted to send it back to Doran, but was unable to do so because Schultz was all over him. Saw some of the Grizzlies play earlier in the day as Garsh tries to weave his way through. And Schultz was doing his familiar refrain of just being a pest to the opposition. Oh, big save there by Mello. Wow, what a save right there on the doorstep at just about the 9-minute mark. So Mello with probably the best save that we've seen today here in the Pro Division. Right out in front. Puck taken back by the Grizzlies. Here they come the other direction. Hustling up the floor was Padilla, and Padilla had it taken off of his stick before he could lace a shot towards the net. Back into his own end with it is Zubak. Zubak, a nice addition to this Grizzlies program. Zubak cut his teeth with Coach Brian Sobel in the Marble Gladiators program. Now finds himself lacing him up here in pro. Here's a break now for the Grizzlies the other way. This is Derek Goff. Goff working inside the circle, running out of space, wrapping it around the boards all the way to Dolce. Turnover forced by the Golden Knights. Walzer's shot was deflected high over the net. They track it back down, and Konant fires it back to Walters. Or actually, that was Olinger. Now Konant with the puck now for the Golden Knights. Over halfway done here in the first half. Pama looking to add to their one-goal lead. Trying to get someone loose. Konant was up ahead of the play. takes the puck away, feeds a man out front, trying to get a shot. Squirts into the corner there as Conant was trying to get a handle on it. Here come the Grizzlies back the other direction. Wasturczyk's pass is intercepted. It goes into the corner. They fight for it there. Olinger, number 91, giving chase for the Golden Knights. They end up with it in front of the Grizzlies bench. Fed across over to Aronson. Aronson pass up the near side boards to Seamer. Seamer trying to step through. He's looking at a two-on-two. Fakes a shot, fakes it, fires one. That one goes wide of the net. Dragging it down is Aronson. Aronson fed it to Olinger. It's knocked away. Dolce trying to get ahead of the pack. Goes out of his reach. Dolce goes down, and we're going to have a penalty called here to Aronson. And Aronson is going to be called for a hold as he sent Dolce down and into the boards. And so the Grizzlies will go on the power player at 6:01 of the first period. Faceoff controlled now by the Golden Knights, but it's stolen back away, and Schultz has it up top now for the Grizzlies. Under 6 minutes to go here in the first period. Schultz with it. He's watched there closely by Nowick. Nowick, Doran, and Walters, the penalty kill unit out there. Nowick got a stick on it. He chases Schultz all the way back down into his own end, and Schultz is forced to twist away, and as he does so, time ticks off the clock. Schultz playing catch on the near side. Now they feed it across. Trying to send it through there and hit the man on the back door was Wasturczyk. And now Nowick battles through a check. Again, takes some of the body. His pass didn't find the mark as he looked for Walters, and Schultz has it and wraps it up the boards. They work it down low. There's a shot right in on Mello. Mello comes away with a nice save there. Here's a chance once again for the Grizzlies. Bad pass behind Dolce. And he had to shoot that one in a hurry, and he fired it wide of the net. We're going to have to hurry. 5 seconds remaining in the power play. Schultz steps into a shot. He tried to go short side. There's a long pass as a man. Aronson comes out of the box. Aronson right up over the shoulder of the goaltender. Fresh out of the box and onto the score sheet. That's how you do it, ladies and gentlemen. 2-0 now. Golden Knights on top. So Aronson right out of the penalty box and into the breakaway goes up high on the shoulder of the goaltender. Trying to walk through. Mello with a nice poke check there. So went over the shoulder of Ochacon. And we have a whistle. As the puck is gloved by Mello, he holds on. 4:04 left to go here in period number one. 2-0 our score here. Grizzlies trailing the Golden Knights. Faceoff chipped back and taken by Wolf. Long pass up ahead. They had a man out front. There's a scramble in front of Mello. Bodies all over the place. And Mello able to hold his ground there and keep the puck out of the net. Nice job there by James. And here comes Aronson back the other direction. He has a second goal. He tries to look for another one. That one is steered into the corner. Goes all the way back to Thomas in his own end, to Olinger. Bodies come together in front of the players' benches. Grizzlies player was kind of stepped over. That was Jeffrey O'Connell. O'Connell walked towards his own bench. There's a shot there. Here's a chance for Olinger. Olinger, nice feet out front. Oh, and there's some good stick there. And let's see if we've... I know Aronson was looking for a penalty call as the trailing Grizzlies player got a stick on top of his, but no call. 2:55 left to go here in the first period. 2-0 our score right now. Faceoff was fought for, and it's finally picked back up by the Grizzlies. Here they come the other direction. Goff slams on the brakes, working outside the circle, coming back up top. ISCA forced to keep it within its own end at this point. 2:22 left to go. They go stretch pass up the far side boards to Schultz. Schultz having some trouble with the puck. Sweeps it all the way back down into his own end. They leave it off for Schultz. Schultz gets bodied into the boards there. Nice play there by Olinger. They come back the other direction, taking a shot right in, and it goes solidly into the chest off the stick of Grizzlies player Derek Groff. So our score here, still 2-0. Golden Knights on top, 1:49 left to go here in our first period as they line up over in front of the Rink Rat Wheel Dasher sign. Rink Rat, one of our sponsors here. Faceoff is controlled. By the Grizzlies, they tried to sweep it up. They were looking for Schultz in front of the net. He was watched there by Doran, and Mello comes out. He's been very aggressive in between the pipes. 1:33 left to go in the first period. 2-0 our score. Face-off controlled now by the Golden Knights. Here comes Doran. Doran working, walking, waiting, shooting. Save made by Ochacone, and the puck comes all the way back down into the Golden Knights' end. They slam on the brakes behind Mello. Leave it for the defenseman there. Closing in on 1 minute left to go here in the first period. Outlet pass up ahead to Aronson. Aronson slides one over to Walzer, whose shot goes over into the corner. Here's a chance the other direction now for Dolce. Dolce, nice one-hand toe drag. Lost it, got it back. Shot! And, oh my gosh, Mello got another piece of that one. I thought that one got behind the goaltender Mello, and he gets a piece of it. It goes out of play, and the faceoff will be to his right, 46 seconds left. Another great save there by Mello. Woof for Padilla, who twists it back into his own end. 35 seconds left to go here in the first half. Back the other direction now with it. Aronson flutters one in towards the net. And ends up in the gloves of Ochacone. And he'll hold on for a whistle with only 22 seconds remaining here in the first period. Faceoff was taken there by Aronson. Now Seymour with it, hands it off. Nowick trying to work wide. Nowick circling behind the net, still waiting for some help. Sends it back up top. There's a long shot, never finds a mark. 3 seconds, two, one. They send it towards the net, and the horn will sound. That'll do it here for our first 15 minutes of action. With the score, the Labeda Golden Knights 2 and the ISCA Grizzlies 0. So we are set to go here with live action in period number two. The Golden Knights have controlled the play in this game, but they are not out of the woods yet. Only a 2-0 lead here as ISCA has kept it close. And they just keep hanging around. They'll continue to try to win faceoffs, though, and in every chance that they get, they'll waste some time off the clock. Here comes Seymour trying to walk his way in. Seymour trying to split the defense, never got a shot truly off there. Good steal there. Seymour had it, lost it as he tried to sweep it back over to Nowick. They feed it up front. Dangerous pass. It's taken back by the Golden Knights. Here's Aronson with it. Aronson has the second goal of the hockey game for Pama. Minute into the second half. Here comes Aronson. Aronson shot. That one goes wide to Ochacon. They fight for it in the corner now. Puck squirts free and it's taken back by Pama. 13:45 left to go here in the second half. Still 2-0. Trying to feed it over to the far side. Making the connection there with Garsh. Garsh sends one towards the net. Ochacon has to come away with the save. Ends up in behind the Grizzlies' net there. Schultz sauces it back, trying to get it. The puck squirts free. Players come together. They battle. Still no whistle. 13:15 left to go. Finally, Pama has it. Thomas couldn't get control of it, though, and back come the Grizzlies the other direction. Working up the floor, trying to go wide. Good defense there by Walters, forcing the play and funneling it to the outside. Now Garsh back the other direction. Pass over to Doran. Doran stepping in from the dot right in on Ochacon, and he gloves it for a whistle. 12:50 left to go here, and the Golden Knights still on top, 2-0. Puck squirts over Thomas's stick, and it's taken back by the Grizzlies' Wolf into his own end. Padilla with it, slamming on the brakes behind Ochacon. Still anybody's hockey game here, 2-0, Golden Knights on top. Trying to weave his way in, tried to feed it in front to Schultz. Schultz may have got a tug on the hand, but he comes away with the loose puck. Sweeps it over to Groff. Here comes Groff working. Ready shot steered aside by Mello. It bounces over into the corner. Groff up on top of it now. Padilla tried to hold up his man. Thomas wheels ahead of him. Shot scores! What a beautiful shot there. And that one finds the top shelf. And at 11:56 of the second period, the Golden Knights extend their lead to 3-0 on a beautiful shot there by the Golden Knights, number 19, Jordan Thomas. Golden Knights extending their lead now to 3-0 on that shot by Thomas. Looking for more. Stepping in, shooting, and that one goes wide of the net by Olinger. Here comes Rissegi back the other way. Austin Rissegi, some of that new blood here in the pro division. His first time lacing him up here in pro. Longtime tour roadrunner. Now playing in the pro division for the ISCA Grizzlies. There's a shot steered aside by Mello up into the netting and in. Did that go into the stands? No, it stayed on the floor. So no souvenirs on that one. 11 minutes exactly remain here in period number two. Puck comes onto the stick of Walzer. Leaves it off there for Olinger. Gets a return pass. Now Walzer up across the red line. Walzer stepping in. Walzer shooting. And that one is steered aside by Ochicone. Probably his best save of the hockey game there. Trying to get something started there as Walzer. Now he finally breaks free. Stepping in, tried to get it onto his backhand and swept off of his stick. Using that big reach, though, to keep it. Trying to steer it out front. He's got help down there with him. It's Parker Conant, number 11. Conant gives it off to Walzer. Now he sends it back up top to Olinger. Thought about a shot. Down low, Conant feeds it in front. Olinger looking for a call as he's shaking off some pain in his hand there. Rasegi sends it back into his own end. Dolce leaves it off there for Wolf as they make personnel changes on both sides. Here comes Schultz now, fresh on the floor. Seamer back the other way for the Golden Knights across the red line. He's got Doran with him. Doran thought about a shot. But that may have gone off of Nowick had he pulled the trigger. Here comes ISCA back the other direction. Trying to walk his way in. It was Wasturczyk. And it ends up with Padilla back in his own end. Reverses it now to Groff. Groff number 9. For the Grizzlies. Gets the return pass back. Here he comes the other direction. Has to slam on the brakes. He lost it momentarily. Seamer's all over him now. It ends up on the stick of Padilla. Padilla's shot steered aside. Goes into the corner. Hits the official, and it's taken back there by the Golden Knights. Nowick working up the far side. Feeding it in front to Seamer. Gets a return pass. He was watched there closely. They come up the boards with it, taken away by Nowick. Nowick thought about a shot. Nowick passed it in front, and Seamer had overskated the scoring zone there. So it sweeps all the way back down into the Golden Knights' end. Slamming on the brakes back there now is Olinger. There's a chance now for the Golden Knights. Seamer. Seamer tried to walk his man. Good defense there by Wasturczyk. Seamer returns a favor as he continues to tug away on Wasturczyk. The shot off the stick at Groff was blocked. And the ensuing play sends it all the way back down into the Grizzlies' end. Time on the side of the Grizzlies at this point. We're on the side of the Golden Knights, 3-0 our score. Pama on top, Pama in the black jerseys, Grizzlies in the white, maybe call it silver jerseys with red trim. Long pass up ahead. Under the stick of Olinger. Now back to Aronson. Aronson makes one move, makes two moves, tries to make a third, and this time it's poked away. And he rings it all the way back down into his own end. There's a pass up the far side boards, but it's stolen back by Padilla. Padilla trying to make a move, sweeps it into the corner. Back up top now. DeGroff. Far side to Zubak. Zubak showing some patience behind his own end. Makes a nice pass there up the boards. Comes to Schultz. Here comes Schultz with it. Schultz twisting, waiting, looking, turning. Comes all the way back into his own end. Puck into the corner now. It's tracked back down by Padilla. Padilla finally brings it back into his own end. Now they'll reset. Masegi leaves it off for Wolf. Interesting line combination out here. We got some old and new. Wolf probably one of the longest tenured players on the Grizzlies out there with Rasegi. So mixing things up, Coach Chelsea. Shot is turned aside there by Ochacon. Clock continuing to roll now. 5:10 left to go here in the second period. Grizzlies still looking to get on the board here if possible. Here come the Golden Knights looking for some more. Sean Garsh. Garsh unable to really get a step, but he's going to draw a penalty here. Possibly a hook or a slash call. So the goaltender Mello heads to the bench. And the extra attacker is out onto the floor, so the penalty rule is into effect. All right, so they have crossed the red line. They cannot bring it back across the red line, or it'll be an immediate whistle at this point with the goaltender on the bench. Doran and Aronson playing catch up top. They finally work it back down low, but it makes its way back up to Aronson. Puck controlled by Aronson up top. Sweeps it over to Doran. Cross ring pass. And back onto the stick of Aronson. Penalty is still being delayed here. Still a 5-on-4 situation. Oh, beautiful play, but couldn't find the mark as he had his stick lifted at the last second. And a nice pass by Conant. And he couldn't handle the pass, and we'll finally get a touch-up, and we're going to get a slashing call against the Grizzlies here at 3:22 of the second period as the Golden Knights are leading this hockey game by a count of 3-0. Face-off control now by the Golden Knights. Comes back up top. They work it down low. Trying to feed it in front. Pass got all the way through. Back up top. Walters goes down low to Garsh. Back up top to Walters. Thought about a shot. Now there's the one-timer, and that one steers wide of the net off the stick.
I heard that reset three.
Of Walzer. There's a shot up off the pipe and in. What a rocket there by Aronson, his second goal of the hockey game. And the Golden Knights extend the lead now to 4-0. Oh, there's going to be a penalty right off the draw. Schultz was taken down on the draw, so we're going to either have a trip or an interference call. It's going to be a trip call. Well, hold on here. There seems to be some confusion. Is the official calling this against the Grizzlies? And he is. He's going to call it on Schultz. So the penalty goes against the Grizzlies, Schultz, for tripping. 2:35 left to go here in the hockey game. And the Golden Knights are on top by a count of 4-0 and on the power play. Aronson with the puck. He's got 2 goals in the hockey game. Looking for possibly a third. They work it back up top to Aronson now. You can tell he's thinking about it as he steps into a shot that goes up off the shoulder of Ochacon. Now we've got a 3-on-1 developing the other way. Here they come. Seamer shot, tried to go low 5-hole, and it ends up under the pads of the goaltender, Ochacon. So 1:48 left to go here in regulation time. Don't think we'll need an extra frame here today. 4-0, Golden Knights our score. Padilla tries to get it. Had it tipped away off his stick. He ends up back down into the corner in the Grizzlies' end. 20 seconds left in the man advantage. Grizzlies trying to generate, trying to get on the board here for the first time in the hockey game. Looking, stepping into a shot. Mello gloves onto that one, and he really can't play it at this point, so hold on for the whistle. 1:21 left to go here in the second period. We've got a whistle here, and it's going to be a penalty coming up against the Golden Knights, and it's going to go against number 11, Parker Conant. So Conant with the penalty. And so now the Golden Knights will be forced to kill off a power play here as Schultz is up and out of the box. Schultz with the puck now at the top of the circle. Thought about stepping into one. Now feeds it across. They work it around the perimeter. 1 minute left to go here in the hockey game. Here comes Schultz. Schultz goes down low, and Mello comes up with a nice save there off the stick of Groff. Face-off control by the Grizzlies. They've done well in that department today. Back up top shot. Groff goes wide of the net. That one, you could hear it all the way up here into the broadcast booth. They battle for it in the corner. Swept back into the corner. Schultz and Walters give chase. Walters tried to clear it down. It's intercepted. Now Dolce with it. 25 seconds left. Dolce steps into a shot, goes wide. Schultz has it, feeds it back up top. Over to Dolce, fake the shot. Now Schultz picks up the redirect as they switch spots. Schultz feeds it across. Shot goes into the corner. Groff up on it. Back up top to Schultz. 8 seconds. 7-6-5. Schultz's shot is gloved by the goaltender Mello. And that will do it here for our hockey game as the Labeda Pama Golden Knights win this one, and a shutout for Mr. Mello. Our final score here from the arena rink, the Golden Knights 4, the ISCA Grizzlies 0. Still more pro action coming up here from the 2017 East Coast NARCh Finals. Jeremy Ellis signing off for the moment.